At this point, I think it will be useful just to let you guys hear from firsthand actual user of Kafka. So for that, I'd like to welcome to the stage Chris Kasten from Walmart Lab. So a lot of people here, of course, know Walmart. For me, I think what impressed me is the growth of Walmart with all those heavy competition from those e-commerce companies. Many of you probably didn't know that Walmart's market cap actually grew 25% just this year, and it reached like an all-time high. And a lot of that probably has to do with its technology and maybe the usage of Kafka. So welcome, Chris, to the stage. To get started, maybe you can just tell us a little bit about yourself and your journey in Kafka.
Yeah, sure. First, I want to thank you for having me be part of your keynote. Sure. You know, it's great to be here. Yeah. I've been following Kafka since it began in 2011 and become an amazing platform. And it's a real testament to the power of open source. So, you know, congratulations to you and Confluent and the success that you guys have had.
Thank you.
Myself, you know, I've been fortunate enough to be a part of multiple Fortune 500 companies over the last 20 plus years, build a lot of high-scale systems and data, core services and frameworks, telemetry, as well as Edge. And in the data platform space, my kind of history with Kafka started out literally at eBay in 2011. Kafka came out, we started playing with it, working with it. Yeah. And we also came to the same realization that LinkedIn did, which was we need what we call the near real-time data platform. You had online, you had offline, but we needed this thing, this near real-time data platform, and we needed something to be the backbone of that. So in about 2013, 14, we started building that system, and we chose Kafka. And actually, we built that system out. It runs actually at eBay today. And we also built it out for PayPal because we actually had a joint platform for a while there. And it's still running at PayPal. I think they do about 5 billion events per day is what I last read. Mm-hmm. So it worked out well there. Built out a huge enablements for security, for personalization, for fraud detection, for search engine optimization, all sorts of different use cases it enabled there. And then fast forward, 3.5 years later, or 3.5 years ago, I came to Walmart, and sure enough, we need that same near real-time data platform.
Right.
So once again, we chose Kafka.
Sounds good. Yeah. Okay, so now about Walmart. Maybe just tell us a little bit about Walmart and its evolution of the technology as you see it.
Yeah, so at Walmart, about 5 years ago, we had a new CEO come in. His name is Doug McMillon. And he started the digital transformation of Walmart. So Walmart was a traditional brick-and-mortar retailer. And he started this digital transformation and making huge investments in technology. And you see that now. You see that we have online grocery, that you come and pick it up at the store, or we can deliver to your house. We have two-day delivery, one-day delivery now. We have the kiosks where you can order it online, and they have a big orange tower that you pull up, put in your QR code, and it gives you your products. So all of these technology investments are going into the company, and you see it reflected in both our growth as a company and our marketplace stock. And Kafka has actually played a very big role in that, in providing that near real-time data system or platform that is messaging throughout the entire infrastructure.
That's good. So what are some of the use cases of Kafka at Walmart?
Yeah, so we use it, as I said, as this backbone, the streaming backbone. So we've used it in our near real-time inventory, so real-time enterprise inventory systems.
Yeah.
Actually, they're going to be giving a presentation on that at 11:40 today,
okay.
So there's a plug for my guys in the crowd. We've used it there. We've used it for fulfillment. We've used it for security. We use it for fraud. We use it for all of the time that you interact with Walmart.com. Every single click is actually streaming out to Kafka, and then it's democratized. Democratization of data for business, for security, for all different aspects that want to consume from it. So you've got all that flow of data feeding the business and providing all of that capability.
Yeah, that's great. So you mentioned earlier like omnichannel, right? So one of the things that's in my mind, or probably not a lot of audience mind, is about the presence of the local stores in retailers like Walmart. A lot of e-commerce companies don't have that. So are those local stores an asset or a liability to companies like Walmart?
That's a great question. Actually, they're a strategic asset and a benefit for us in that Walmart, so most people don't know this, there is a Walmart within 10 miles of 90% of the population of the United States. So within 10 miles of 90% of the population of the United States, we have a place that you can come and interact with us. So however you want to interact with us in that omni-channel customer experience, if you want to order online and have it delivered to your house, if you want to order it online and pick it up at the store, if you want to come into the store, everybody wants to shop differently, and we provide them that omni-channel experience, and we're able to provide that supply chain. We built that supply chain over decades, and it allows us to have a competitive advantage over the rest of e-commerce.
Yeah, that sounds very interesting. Okay. So another question is about the grocery store. So that's like a big part, right, of other retailers. And then within Walmart, I understand that's actually a growing business. Can you talk about some of the experience you guys had on the grocery store?
Yeah, grocery is growing huge. It is one of our fastest growing segments. It's great. You know, you have the soccer mom or dad at the game. They're ordering their groceries. They punch it in. And then on the way home, they choose when they want to pick it up. They pull up within 5 minutes. We walk out. We put it in the back of the car, and they drive away. We get selfies all the time of moms with sleeping kids in the back of the car just saying, thank you so much. You saved me from dragging them into the store. And we just pull up and give them that. So, you know, Kafka also enables that from the beginning to the end. From the time that they're interacting with the app, we're actually taking all that user behavioral data, it's going into Kafka. When they place the order, our order management system, it flows into Kafka. When they actually go to the store and they're picking, those events flow into Kafka. And when they actually fulfill it, that event goes into Kafka. So it's all throughout the entire ecosystem. But we're not stopping there, actually. We actually have announced that this fall, we're going to, for 1 million customers in 3 regions, actually deliver groceries to your refrigerator in your house. So we now have a video camera mounted to our associate. They walk up. They have a smart box on the door. They go in. They start the video camera. It live feeds to your phone. You see them walk in. They see them stock your refrigerator. They leave, turn off the video, and it's now delivered into your refrigerator. So even more. So a lot of great things coming from Walmart. Right. We didn't touch about that's 11 billion events per day that we process in Kafka. So 8,500 nodes that we manage, and it all runs all of this great infrastructure. So we're just doing great things, having a lot of fun at Walmart.
Right. That's great. That's interesting. Okay, one last question from me. Of course, Walmart is a customer of Confluent. So what's your guys' experience with vendors like Confluent?
Yeah, you know, we are a $500 billion in revenue company, so every second counts, that's millions of dollars, and having Confluent as that expert for us to provide us that support if we need it, and also partner with us in best practices, blueprints, and also providing you know, new features to the product, it's been a great experience. So we enjoy our partnership with Confluent. We really find them as a valuable partner, so it's been great.
Great. So with this, thanks for coming. And then thanks for making Walmart not only just a good place to shop, but also a great place to work, sounds like it.
Yeah, thanks for having us and letting us kind of show some of the fun we're having at Walmart and the great things that we're doing with Kafka.
Great. Okay, thank you again.